Historically, it was a usual morning of 14th March 1931, when we were fighting to liberate our country under the leadership of Mahatma Gandhi. But simultaneously, it was an unusual day in the history of Indian cinema. The day is marked as a milestone in Indian cinema, as the first talking feature film, Alam Ara, was released in Majestic Cinema Bombay, now called Mumbai. Alam Ara is a love story between a gypsy girl and a rich guy, which was directed by Ardesar Irani and produced by Imperial Theatres. The first film took the audiences by surprise and they became hysterical, so much so that the police forces were called to control the crowd. There were 7 songs in the film and they all became popular overnight.
Khan Bahadur Ardesar Irani, unhone pehle ye taki film banayi, isme father ka role Prithviraj ji ne kiya tha.
Tanar single system camera, recording image and sound simultaneously, revolutionized the way Indian films were shot.
बहुत हंगामा हो गया था, लोग समझ ही नहीं पा रहे थे क्या हो गया, और तब कलकत्ते से साइकिल आते थे, यहाँ से सुरेंद्र नाथ बीए एलएलबी आते थे, मोतीलाल थे, पहले सारी एक्टिंग वो अपना क्या कहते हैं ना, स्टेज ही होती थी।
खूनी,
मैं खूनी?
हाँ, तू खूनी, मेरे पिताजी का खून तूने ही किया चांडाल।
नहीं, मैं उसे तो बांध दे चुका हूँ। मैं जाऊंगा, मैं उसके पास जाऊंगा।
अति सुंदर प्यारा प्यारा, एक तो बंगला बने न्यारा।
Indian cinema is popular for its candid dialogues, melodious songs, and extravagant dance. Looking back at the earlier days, it is hard to believe that between 1913 to 1930. Films were silent.
The silent cinema was never as such silent. It was always accompanied with sound, but live sound. Minimum you would require in a small town even would be at least a tabla player and a violinist. So the films already had a dimension of sound, music was added. If there was a chase sequence, the sounds of the horses and the feet, running feet, was imitated on the tabla.
Most of these films were mythological and it dealt with our ancient stories commonly popular in the society.
All the major genres that we identify with the mature talkie film in India
were developed already in the silent period. Of course, the mythological, the social, the crime film, even sensational melodramas were made at that time. Unfortunately, most of those films are lost.
Silent के जमाने में हम जो भी डायलॉग बोलते थे, बीच में कार्ड आया करता था, क्या बोल रहे हैं, किससे बोल रहे हैं, ये सब होता था. तो हम लोग क्या करते थे, जैसे हीरोइन से मुझे प्यार करना है, मैं कहता था, अरे उल्लू की पट्टी, तू कहाँ थी, तेरा कितना इंतजार किया, तू आई नहीं. खाना तो तैयार रखा होता, आई क्यों नहीं तुम. तो कार्ड में आता था, माय डार्लिंग, आई लव यू, आई एम वेटिंग फॉर यू.
द पॉपुलैरिटी ऑफ स्टार्स इंक्रीज, द पॉपुलैरिटी ऑफ म्यूजिक ऑफ कोर्स व्हिच वाज न्यू, ऑफ सॉन्ग्स, एंड द इंडियन सिनेमा बिगन टू प्ले द रोल ऑफ अ ग्लू, यू नो, ऑफ क्रिएटिंग, यू नो, द आइडिया ऑफ आइडेंटिटी ऑफ अ नेशन.
साउंड गेव टंग टू सिनेमा. But what happened in India, it came not one but many tongues. You know, it became possible for the Indian filmmaker to make films in umpteen number of languages, in all the regional languages. So apart from the national language Hindi, it became possible for filmmakers to make films in their own regional language, Bengali, Marathi here, and in the south, Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, and Malayalam, and also other regional languages in Assam and everything.
மலர்ந்த மலர்கள் வண்ணம் கமல் சென்ற பகல் தருது மனமோகனமே.
எவரி லாங்குவேஜ் traces back its origin to the first language, first film, talkie film made in that language. Ayodhya Raja is supposed to be the first talkie in Marathi made by Prabhat.
Talkie pictures played a major role in the rise of the studio system. Prabhat in Pune, Ranjit Movie Tone, Wadia Brothers, Minerva Movie Tone and Bombay Talkies were flourishing in Bombay, while New Theatre in Bengal, Vijaya Vahini Productions and later Gemini and AVM in South were actively involved in the talkies films.
Pictures hoti thi us zamane mein, company a picture banati thi aur company ke naam pe chalta tha. Jis tarah hota tha ki bhai ye New Theatre ki picture hai, तो ये नहीं सोचते थे कि भाई उसमें साइकिल है या नहीं. न्यू थिएटर की पिक्चर आई, बॉम्बे टॉकीज की पिक्चर आई, रंजीत की आई या प्रभात की आई, कंपनी के नाम पिक्चरें चलती थी.
स्टूडियो हैड टू बी साउंड प्रूफ्ड, सो फिल्म्स वर शॉट ओनली इन द नाइट्स, यू नो, इन द अर्ली पीरियड, सो दैट दिस आउटसाइड देयर आर नो ट्रैफिक साउंड्स एंड सो ऑन, एंड द कैमरा हैड टू बी मोर स्टैटिक.
यू हैव द साउंड मैन बिकमिंग द टॉप टेक्नीशियन इन द सेट. Even the camera has to be set up in such a way that the boom and the boom doesn't come inside the frame. So all this technical devolution and people have to adjust to that thing.
Sound okay? Sound okay?
एक रूम बना हुआ रहता था जहाँ रिकॉर्डिंग होती थी पूरी. जब शुरू शॉट होता था तो पिन ड्रॉप साइलेंट होता था, कि एक सायरन जैसे बेल बजती थी, एक बूम रहता था पूरा. हाँ, वो जो बूम मैन जो एक्सपर्ट होता था उसको रिदम से बूम चलाना है, उसकी शैडो भी नहीं आनी चाहिए कैमरा में.
रोल कैमरा,
रोलिंग,
एक्शन.
Some of the technicians were envious of the sound man in the first 4 or 5 years of the sound period. People had too much of importance given to dialogues, and they were all have to speak their own dialogues. And if it is not okay, you have to take number 2 and take number 3.
Boom man ka credit uske upar tha ki pura aise jaise crane operate hote waise boom operate hota tha. Yani trolley chali samjho, trolley shot hoga to boom man ट्रॉली के साथ चलता रहता था. कोई गलती होगी तो वहाँ से साउंड रिकॉर्डिंग रूम से बोलता था कि इसमें गलती है, रिटेक.
कट, इज एवरीथिंग ओके?
कैमरा ओके?
साउंड, साउंड ओके? अरे क्या हुआ भाई, बूम नीचे करो, एक बार दूसरे टेक करेंगे. चलो,
उस जमाने में रिकॉर्डिंग मशीन अच्छे होते भी नहीं थे, तो आपको विस्पर करना पड़ता था, चिल्ला करना पड़ता. फिडल टोन था, बहुत ही वीक, और फिल्म भी थे इतने सेंसिटिव नहीं थे कि लाइट बहुत लगता था, बहुत लाइट लगते थे. अरे जिसको ब्रूट्स कहते हैं वो लगाते थे, एकदम गर्म, बहुत गर्म लगता था.
Until the coming of sound, 1931-32, the transition period is 3 years. Silent films were still made up to 1934. A majority of the films released in 1932, it's not realized, or 31, were silent still. It took all the studios a lot of investment and time to find technicians to move to sound. So there was a 3 years transition period. But once all these transitional things have happened, it is a commonly known fact. 85% saw in 1931 foreign films in India. 15% only the indigenous Indian product. This whole ratio within 5 years, from 1931 to 36, got reversed. 85% was the audience was for watching Indian language films of South, East, Hindi, Marathi, the whole range of languages, and only 15% for foreign.
ब्रह्म ऋषि संत यमुनक ज्ञान दृष्टि संपन्न लोग मेरे लिए ये मंद हो।
Really the true rise of the Indian film is in the late 30s when different South Indian languages, Tamil particularly and Telugu, Bengali, though also in Bengal bilinguals were made, Bengali and Hindi. Bombay cinema, which was the dominant cinema even in those days, and Marathi cinema, and in Pune, Prabhat also made bilinguals, Hindi for the national market and Marathi for the local market.
Then in 1932, Prabhat produced their first talkie, called as Ayodhya Raja. Days, none of the partners had any knowledge about the sound recording. Even they were not familiar with any sound recording equipments. That time my grandfather Vishnupanta Damle took a lead and he bought camera and recording system from Mumbai. He himself got educated about how to record the sound. Then the first talkie, which was produced by Prabhat in 1932, he did the sound recording. We can say proudly that this is the oldest available talkie movie which we are having in India.
Other than providing a new kind of spectacle to the masses, the talkies resulted in recognizing the importance of the spoken language. Talkie films led to the popularity of not only the regional languages like Marathi, Bengali, Tamil, Gujarati or Assamese, but also our national language Hindi.
हमने भी बहुत से महाराज देखे हैं और बहुत से महाराजों को जीता भी है मगर तीर और तलवार की सौगंध आप जैसा ओछा और शेखी खुराज तक नहीं देखा।
आगा हाशर कश्मीरी फॉर एग्जांपल द फेमस पारसी थिएटर प्लेराइट ही वाज वर्किंग नॉनस्टॉप फॉर न्यू थिएटर्स यू नो अंटिल डायलॉग राइटर्स लाइक केदार शर्मा एंड यू नो इन प्रभात स्टूडियो हैड इट्स ओन डायलॉग राइटर्स They came into their own. Early dialogue writing was done by theatre personalities.
Immediately after Alam Ara, Kalidas was released in Tamil and Telugu, marking it as the first South Indian talkie film.
When talkies came, there was a shock. Then, when the people who were talking were on stage.
Coming of the sound cinema meant a new kind of star also came in, the singing star. Most legendary, of course, is K.L. Saigal. He would not be the big star he was without his voice.
Gana, jo aaj bhi zaruri hai ek film mein, gaane shuru hue. Lar lappa lai rakhda,
adi tappa lai rakhda. The songs, they clicked right away. It became the identifying feature of Indian sound film. That irrespective of genre, there will be songs.
Film music, as we understand now, came from Lahore in a film called Kajanji, which was made in 1940. Beginning at the height of the war period. There the Punjabi folk music, that is the dholak, that became the main instrument instead of the harmonium. Otherwise the basic instrument in the 30s was the harmonium. But this dholak brought in a totally different rhythm to the film music, and that we can call it the Punjabi folk music. Ghulam Haider was a famous music director who brought in a Punjabi folk music in a big way. And that became the trend of the Hindi films of the 40s.
साइकिलें रखते थे साइकिलें होती थी उसके ऊपर तख्ता रखते थे उसके ऊपर कैमरा होता था और वो साइकिलें चलाते थे लोग और वो उसका ये अपने ट्रॉली शॉट
सामने म्यूजिशियंस आ गए थे और सरस्वती देवी क्या करती थी अपने मेट्रोनोम लिए देख लेते टाइम फिक्स कर लिया हाँ अब गाओ तो मैं कहता हूँ मैं बन की चिड़िया बन के कट सुर बेसुरा हो गया फिर से शुरू करूँ पूरा साहब एक शॉट में ले लिया जाता था एंड तक फिर कहते कैमरा बदलो उधर उधर रहो डायरेक्टर, कैमरा बदला वो तो मेट्रो ने चलाया कट 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 कट, हाँ ये टाइमिंग है अब फिर से गाओ। तो इस तरह से हम लोग को पूरा गाना तीन दफे चार दफे गाना पड़ता है, एडिटर काट काट के उसको ठीक करता था।
साउंड वॉज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट उस टाइम भी, प्रभात के टाइम भी और लास्ट इवन राजकमल में जब शांताराम जी आए, ही वॉज ऑल्सो वेरी पर्टिकुलर अबाउट दिस साउंड सिस्टम। आई रिमेंबर ही वॉज टेलिंग मी कि उस टाइम जो लाइव गाने होते थे दैट वॉज एक्चुअली नॉट रिकॉर्डेड, इट वॉज ऑलरेडी संग ऑन द सेट विद द आर्टिस्ट विद तबला हारमोनियम एवरीथिंग।
मैंने भी गाने की कोशिश की एक दफे और प्रोफेसर देवधर म्यूजिक डायरेक्टर थे उस जमाने में, उन्होंने कहा कि जय ऐसी कोई बात नहीं मैं तुझे गाना सिखा दूंगा, तो उन्होंने एक महीना मुझे गाना सिखाया।
साउंड रेडी रेडी।
तो जब टेक का दिन आया तो चले गए लोकेशन के ऊपर और मैंने गाना शुरू किया। पता लगा कि मेरी आवाज़ जो है मद्रास जा रही है और साजिंदर जा रहे हैं दिल्ली। पूछने लगे क्या हुआ यार, मैंने कहा मैं तो गा रहा हूँ मगर मुझे आवाज़ सुनने में नहीं आ रही है।
अरे जोर से बजाओ जरा जोर से। ओके ओके ओके। साउंड रेडी रेडी।
सब लाइव पार्टी, आर्टिस्ट नहीं है, म्यूजिशियन नहीं है, ऐसा कुछ नहीं है, आर्टिस्ट के साथ हम लोग बजाते थे।
I can't tell you anything about Alam Ara, but as my daddy was involved with the picture, he was telling us stories, you know, like first of all, Imperial Studio was just near the railway line. So they had to do shooting in the night only. So every 2 minutes, train used to pass. Na? And then musicians are like, you have to move around. Na? Wherever the artist mic is there, they have to go near that mic. Na? Otherwise, sound won't come. And mic is only one microphone for all of us at that time.
Action!
सुर नहीं आ रहा है, आवाज नहीं आ रही है।
थोड़ा पास।
अरे आप लोग आगे आ जाओ कैमरा, सब क्लोजअप ले लो, लेंस चेंज करो।
एक बहुत खूबसूरत स्किट है जय के पास जो पहले सुनाया करते थे, पता नहीं उनको अभी तक याद है ये नहीं। वो कहते थे जब हम बॉम्बे टॉकीज में काम करते थे तो पोस्टर्स कैसे बनते थे आपको मालूम है? मैंने कहा जी मुझे नहीं मालूम। कहने लगे पोस्टर्स मैं साउंड इफेक्ट से बताऊंगा। मैंने कहा ठीक जैसे मर्जी। तो उन्होंने शुरू किया बॉम्बे टॉकीज प्रेजेंट्स देवी का रानी इन हमारी बात विद जयराज। हम लोगों का नाम यू आया करता था।
धीरे धीरे आ रे बादल धीरे आ रे बादल धीरे धीरे जा मेरा बुलबुल सो रहा है, मेरा बुलबुल सो रहा है शोरगुल न मचा धीरे धीरे।
इस पर में जो गाने हैं ना, गानों को आप देखेंगे कि वो गाना निकाल दीजिए तो स्टोरी थोड़ी कम पड़ जाती है। वो गाने में स्टोरी बोला जाता है, स्टोरी बोला गया हर में, हर गाने में, हर गाने में स्टोरी बोला गया, तो इसलिए वो चिपक गया गाने के साथ, स्टोरी के साथ ग्रिप कर जाता है।
Those days songs were like a part of a story. If you miss one song, if you go out for that song, you won't understand. You will say, what happened suddenly? Jump kaisa aa gaya the story mein.
With language comes in culture. The Bengali cinema, for example, or the Marathi language cinema, or the Kannad cinema, or the Telugu cinema, brought in the culture of those regions. So much of culture and identity is tied up with language.
তোমাকে আত্মা চলে যাবার ইচ্ছা আছে?
হ্যাঁ আছে, কিন্তু এবার একা নয়।
The religious fanaticism started being questioned. And so that is why you can see untouchability is a recurring theme, not only from social point of view, but even in mythologicals. There is a film called Bhakta Nandanar, made in the South by Jamini. Basically, it is about not a high caste Hindu. And that is the conflict in the basic conflict in the film. You know, because he is from the Dalit community or the lower caste. So that kind of things were taboos were, you know, eradicated slowly by through these social reform films, both in the Hindi language and in the regional languages.
Tum Brahman ho, main Achhut.
Achhut Kanya of Bombay Talkies, directed by Franz Austin for Himanshu Rai, dealt with Achhut Kanya. Well, you cannot have a more explicit title, Untouchability.
A film like Chandidas, made in Calcutta, both in Bengali and it is about a Brahmin priest falling in love with a washerwoman.
Rami, kisi ka bade aur kisi ka chote ghar mein janm lena, ye manushya ki ichha aur adhikar mein nahi.
Essentially, at the New Theatres, Calcutta, most of the problems of playback and pre-recorded sound were settled. New Theatres really did the pioneering work as far as the soundtrack is concerned. But the really creative work came from, say, people like V. Shantaram, who used sound in a brilliant, brilliant manner. Like Dunya Na Maane, which is about age difference between a widower and a young teenager getting married.
There is a wonderful scene in which when he accepts his mistake. The sindoor, that is the kunku, is the symbol of marriage.
Dharmacha navano tujhavar ladlela he saubhagya mis nahi sakarto.
Then he says, okay, I'm not going to put the sindoor as your man or your husband.
Pati mhanun nave, pita mhanun.
That's, you know, very interesting twist on the part of the filmmakers at that time. You know, Shantaram is the real credit goes to him. So in a split of a second, the husband becomes the father.
Growing demands of the talkie films led to the construction of new cinema halls, which could showcase and accommodate the incredible and unending number of audiences. The Indian society was also slowly opening up to the idea of this new kind of entertainment. And while cinema viewing was earlier restricted to a certain section of the society, the talkies brought the middle class as well to the theatres.
When the sound started coming into the film, it changed, you know, audience started listening to the audio or the sound. For them, it was, they were having more impact of that particular film.
Dekh, tere kareeb baap ne duniya bhar ki cheeze dehej mein di. Dekh, dekh.
Us time ke parliament logon ne ye film wahan mangayi thi. Us time Jawaharlal Nehru was the prime minister, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel was the home minister.
Ek cheez to dena.
Film देखने के बाद, the government of India has passed an anti-dowry bill in the Indian Constitution. उसके पहले नहीं था. फिल्म का impact जो क्या होता है लोगों पे, वो मालूम पड़ता है उसमें.
Coming of sound in Indian cinema in 1930s is seen as a positive change as it gave Indian cinema a distinct identity on the global map of world cinema. Even to this day, Hollywood films find it tough to penetrate the Indian film market. This has largely been due to the presence of film songs in the narrative. The Indian cinema has grown multiple folds and has evolved to where we are today, and is at present the world's largest film industry. In a country where the masses are deprived of means of public entertainment, cinema is doing well to bridge that gap.
Quite correctly, we say there is not one Indian cinema. There are many Indian cinemas.